Hello children, today we will start from the 12th chapter of GK, that is flightless birds. Okay, so flightless birds, as the name says, that the birds which cannot fly, that is flightless birds. So write the names of these birds using the help box. Okay, help box is given, some words names are given. So first is kiwi. First bird is kiwi, K-I-W-I, kiwi. Kiwi is a bird from New Zealand. It is a brown color flightless bird. Second picture is of cassowary. This cassowary is from New Guinea and Australia. C-A-S-S-O-W-A-R-Y. Third picture is of ostrich. Ostrich is a large flightless bird and it is a native to Africa. Third is ostrich. Fourth is kakapo, K-A-K-A-P-O, kakapo. It is also all known as owl parrot, okay, and this bird is from New Zealand. Fifth picture is of rhea, R-H-E-A, rhea. It is from South America. Sixth picture is of penguin. You can easily find out this, and this lives in the southern hemisphere. It's an aquatic bird, okay, P-E-N-G-U-I-N, penguin. Seventh is Galapagos cormorant, G-A-L-A-P-A-G-O-S, Galapagos, C-O-R-M-O-R-A-N-T, cormorant. This belongs to island of Ecuador, this Galapagos cormorant. Eighth picture is of emu, and this bird is from Australia. I repeat, number one kiwi, number two is cassowary, number three ostrich, number four is kakapo, number fifth rhea, sixth is penguin, seventh Galapagos cormorant, and eighth is emu. Now children, at the bottom it is given, now know with Derek, the inaccessible island rail is the smallest known flightless bird in the world. So this you underlined and you learn it. Okay, it lives on the inaccessible land island located in the South Atlantic Ocean. So name of the bird you can underline and you have to learn it. Now come to next chapter 13. Identify these creatures. Identify the creatures shown in the picture. Choose your answer from the help box. It has a zebra-like marking on its legs. So you can see in the picture, zebra-like marking is there. This animal is okapi. O-K-A-P-I. Okapi. Second, the petrels produced by Hermione Granger takes the shape of this animal. Okay, this animal is otter. O-T-T-E-R, otter. Third, native to South America, its wool is very expensive. This animal is vicuna. V-I-C-U-N-A. Fourth, it is easily identified by its colorful bill, short wing and short tail with black upper parts and brownish gray underparts. So this animal is puffin, P-U-F-F-I-N, puffin. Fifth is mountain goat with long curved horns. It is ibex, I-B-E-X, ibex. Sixth one, this bird gives advice to Dora the explorer. This is toucan, T-O-U-C-A-N. Again, so I repeat, number one is okapi, number two is otter, number three is vicuna, number fourth puffin, number fifth ibex, and number six is toucan. Now come to chapter number 14, trees in India. Unscramble the words and write the names of the trees in the plants. So first is a dash, I'll call it dash. Tree has structures that grow down from the branches to the ground and that grow into new roots and trunks. So you can see in the picture also it is banyan tree. B-A-N-Y-A-N, banyan. Twigs from the N dash tree are used for brushing teeth in India. It is very good for, you know, when you can use it for brushing teeth also. It is neem, N-E-E-M. It is a herbal tree, neem. The wood of the dash tree is used in making incense sticks and perfumes. It is sandalwood, S-A-N, D-A-L, sandal, W-O-O-D, sandal, wood, that is Chandan, we say it in Hindi. The dash tree is believed to give the Sundarbans its name. This Sundari, S-U-N-D-A-R-I, Sundari. The dash tree is called the tree of life because of the number of products and byproducts we get from it. This coconut, C-O-C-O-N-U-T, coconut. The dash tree is also known as Bodhi tree. It is people, P-E-P-A-L, people tree. So first is banyan, second neem, third is sandalwood, fourth is sundari, fifth coconut, and sixth is people. So children, this lesson, three lessons we will do it today, and you fill it in your book. Thank you.